Happy Monday, all you minties. Uncanny Omar here from Near Mint Condition, the home of collected editions. And join me today for your advanced look at the Predator, the original Years Omnibus from Marvel Comics. It's finally here. Stay tuned. Okay, here we have Predator, the original Years Marvel Omnibus. Before going any further, though, I want to thank the kind folks at Marvel and David Gabriel for sending us an advanced copy of this Omnibus. This Omnibus is due out in Direct Market and Book Market on December 27th or 28th, depending on where you get your books. This here is the standard edition cover. And on the left-hand side is the Direct Market cover. This is by Chris Warner, and this one over here by Iban Coelho. And this is from the Concrete Jungle trade paperback, but also used for a couple of other covers, which we'll look at on the inside. So here's what the spines look like. They are different, the Direct Market cover here and a standard edition cover here. And then the back of the book right here with all the different covers. The price down here, $125. And these are just some of the covers of the comics collected in here. And mature content. And that is violence, mainly language, and some sexual situations, if you will. We are talking about Predator, and if anybody's seen Predator 2, actually the Predator 2 adaptation is in here. And everything else on the inside, though, is the same. But before I look at the dust jacket, I did want to say, I will be giving this one away. Before our next giveaway, I wanted to do something a little bit special for the people that watch all my videos. So all you have to do to enter, I'll do a random name picker and announce the winner on the Saturday Q&A this coming Saturday. So that will be Saturday, December 31st. But if you want, I'm keeping the standard edition copy. If somebody wants the Direct Market cover, that's a cool cover. I love that cover, but I don't need to. All you have to do is in the comments down below, tell me what your favorite Predator movie is. That's it. And then I'll do a random number or name generator, rather. Now we can look at what's underneath the dust jacket. And again, I'll let all the entries come in until December 30th. So I can announce the winner by December 31st. So good luck. And it's open to anybody, by the way. Overseas. And even though I just sent a bunch of packages over there, but I love paying it forward. So what we have here, it's this nice splash painting right here from one of the covers of the stories in here. All right, speaking of stories, we are going to be looking at the stories collected in here, looking at the artwork. So I'll be talking a little bit about them and how they have, if any, ties to the original Predator or Predator 2 movie and the page count. And of course, look at the build of this book. Okay, let's go ahead and get this open. Have some black end paper there. Predator, as you're looking at a Predator with their visor on, that mask that they wear. And here we have the credits, Predator, the original Years, Volume 1. I think there is enough material for a Volume 2 and then an Aliens vs. Predator Omnibus, which would be so awesome. Here are all the credits. Mark Verheiden, John Arcudi, Neil Barrett Jr., Ian Edgington, Evan Dorkin, and Terry LeBon, Brian McDonald. These are some names that you may be familiar with if you have been reading the Aliens Omnis. So a lot of the creators are very similar. And before we get to the first comic, here we have the table of contents where you're going to find each of the books that are collected in here when the books were originally published. So if you're noticing something, we go from June 1989 all the way down to March of 1997, and it is collected in publishing order. It doesn't matter that Predator 2, I believe Predator 2 takes place in 1997, and some of these stories later on take place in 1996. It is collected in publishing order, which I like. Otherwise, the John Schaefer stories would be all together, and I'll talk a little bit more about the character here in a second. But this does collect Predator, the 1989 series, 1 through 4, and Predator 2, that's the comic adaptation of the movie, 1 and 2, The Big Game, 4-issue miniseries, Cold War, 4-issue miniseries, Bloody Sands of Time, that's 2 issues of that, and Bad Blood, 1 through 4, Invaders from the Fourth Dimension one-shot, Dark River 4-issue miniseries, The Kindred 4-issue miniseries, Strange Rue one-shot, and then material from Dark Horse Presents 46-119, material from Dark Horse Comics 1 and 2, 4 through 7, 10 through 14, 16 through 18, 20 through 21, and a decade of Dark Horse 1. So that's what this collects in this particular collection. So I do think there is enough for a volume 2. So the very first story, this is where we meet a character named John Schaefer. And John Schaefer is a New York police officer. He's a this is his partner right here. What is his name? Roche. And both of them are investigating a bunch of gang wars and something going on between the gangs. Like, there's been skinning and there's been just some weird deaths. So again, this has mature content. Like, there's lots of violence, things you're going to see in here. People's heads getting blown off, decapitation. And one very important thing that I always like to note, in case you love animals and you can't stomach them getting hurt, whether through television or in comic books or in books, there's a lot of that happens here. A lot of animals get hurt, because we are talking about a predator that doesn't care what type of animal you are. It's going to hunt you down. So he's investigating these crimes that are going on through New York City, and this is his partner. So you can tell Schaefer's a really big, kind of a one-dimensional type of character. Now, if you've watched the Predator movie, the character of Dutch, this is his big brother, John. And this takes place 3 years after the first movie. So Predator 1 came out in 1986, this takes place in 1989. And John is wondering whatever happened to his little brother. Just so weird to call Arnold somebody's little brother. But here he meets somebody from the military, and he's like, oh yeah, Dutch saved my life a lot of times. Look, what I'm about to tell you is off the record. So he knows something weird's going on. So the more that both him and his partner do the investigating against their captain's wishes, they run into the Predator. So This is so ridiculous. Like, he just starts duking it out with him, knocks off his mask, and then he takes his mask, he gets thrown off a building, but not before this Predator puts in a tracker on this guy. This is John Schaefer again. Like, gets knocked down the building. That's where issue 1 ends. Issue 2 picks up where he's falling off of this building, and he survives. And his partner's like, yo, what was that? John doesn't even blink an eye. He's like, it must be some kind of creature that's going around and killing all the gang members. Now, I think in order to enjoy this book more, you have had to have seen at least the Predator movie, the very first one. That at least. I mean, yeah, sure, you could watch all of them, Predator 2 and Predators and Prey, which is awesome. I really enjoyed it. Actually, there's a story in here that reminds me of Prey. But in order to get the most out of this book, I think you've had to have seen the very first Predator movie. John Schaefer is your one-dimensional type of 80s, early 90s hero. Just super muscular, testosterone-driven, and so many cheesy lines. Like, more one-liners and quips than Spider-Man, I swear. It's like, I don't know who wrote this, but it really, really reminds me of those 80s movies and 90s movies. You know, the Steven Seagal movies, the movies with Jean-Claude Van Damme. The type of movies that I really enjoyed growing up, like the canon films. Just the most horrific dialogue that you wouldn't really say when you're confronting a giant creature that's about to slaughter you. And you've seen him slaughter all kinds of different people. So that's the type of stories that are in here. And I'm not exaggerating when I say that the one-dimensional characters are what you're going to find through here, especially with the character of John Schaefer, who shows up in multiple stories. He shows up in the first story, and then he shows up in, I believe, the fourth story that's collected in here. We get a little bit of This Is God's Truth. Love that cover, right? That is gorgeous. That is a beautiful cover. This is the only black and white mini story that's collected in here. And then we jump into the adaptation of Predator 2, which they wanted to star Arnold Schwarzenegger, but however, he couldn't make it. Or I think he was committed to doing something else. So they got Danny Glover as Mike Harrigan to come in. He plays a detective, this time taking place in LA and not New York. And one thing you're going to notice is that there's a lot of similarities between this adaptation and the movie. That was a stupid statement. I'm so sorry. Let me backtrack. There's a lot of similarities in the movie and the Concrete Jungle story, the very first four-issue miniseries, because it takes place in the city. The Predator is coming down to hunt down a bunch of gangs, so there's an inter-gang war. So there's a lot of similarities that you may notice that they pulled from those stories to adapt into the second movie. There is a cool twist later on that they didn't do in the second movie that I really enjoyed in the first book. So I guess I stand by my statement when I said that there's a lot of similarities between this and the movie, because yes, I was mainly talking about this story here, this comic adaptation, because it is true. So you do see the characters of Bill Paxton. Love that guy. Gone way too soon. And who else was in this? Maria Conchita Alonso, I think, was in this movie. But you see the fight with the Predator between him and Danny Glover. It's only two issues. And then we move on to the big game here. And the big game's a little bit different. This tells the legend of... It's a Navajo legend of the Horned Monster. And you meet the character of Nakai, who is a Navajo soldier. And he wants to hunt down this creature. He wants to take down this creature because he believes that it is the Horned Monster who was destroyed by the hero. And I cannot remember the hero's name. So this mythical monster is going to be slayed by him, who... I guess he considers himself the monster slayer. But that's what that four-issue miniseries is. And then we go back to the story, in a weird way, of John Schaefer. And this is the Cold War. So all of this takes place... Yeah, this is issue number two. This time around in Siberia. And he ends up teaming up with a Russian soldier. And what is her name? Lieutenant Ligachev? Ligachev, I think, is how... You pronounce it, or her name. Somewhere close to that. So they have to deal with another party of predators. And actually, I think this is my favorite of the John Schaefer, trilogy. Because he shows up again. Because of her. I like that type of character. She's a lot more than just one-dimensional type of 80s hero. So I really enjoyed this one more. This is the Bloody Sands of Time. And the Bloody Sands of Time is... ups and downs with this one here. It's I like the character of both Gwen and Griggs, but I think it focused more on the horrors of war than it focused more on the actual characters and the Predator. But this, I think, is the one that stands out above all the rest, in my opinion, and that is the Rite of Passage story. And this is just a short story by Ian Edginton, and it is drawn by one of my favorite artists, Rick Leonardi. And it has no dialogue, and it just follows a gentleman here from this particular tribe in Africa. And he's hunting one day. He sees a falling star, and he goes back to his tribe, and everybody has been slaughtered. Now, I say everybody, but that's the way it looks. Like I said, there's no dialogue. But we know that the Predator doesn't go after innocent people, or people that can't do any harm, people that don't have weapons. I mean, we see him avoid pregnant people, right? Pregnant ladies, like we did in Predator 2. Or we see him avoid children. Although in Predator 2, when that kid picks up the toy gun, he has to make sure that the gun is a toy. But anyway, I assume that his whole tribe was slaughtered. This story here reminds me of Prey, the recent movie. I thought, because of the lack of dialogue, even though Prey had more dialogue, of course, this type of underdog character was able to defeat the Predator. Maybe, maybe not. You can find out for yourself. That's the last I'm going to flip through here. But it was my favorite story that was collected in here. I thought it was excellent. It's a silent short, and like I said, reminded me of Prey. This is the Blood Feud story. That's like a samurai, modern samurai story featuring the character of Juta. And this story right here takes us back to Africa. This is the Pride of Ngaza, I believe is how you pronounce it. It really reminds me of like those hunting stories where, they take somebody out on a safari and those guys are out there hunting. And then, of course, it turns out that the actual hunter is the Predator. It's a good take on those particular stories. This next story is Dark Horse Comics, 12 through 14. But it leads into the Bad Blood four-issue miniseries. As a matter of fact, that's what we're looking at here. And the Bad Blood miniseries and the mini or the little stories from Dark Horse Comics, those were all written by Evan Dorkin, and it's actually penciled by Derek Thompson, both the Dark Horse Comics issues that lead into this, and then the Bad Blood 4-issue miniseries. This one's an interesting take on the story of the Predator, because the story deals with this wildly psychotic Predator that is out on the hunt, but there are other Predators that are hunting that crazy Predator down, the one that has bad blood. And I thought this was an interesting take on the whole mythos of the Predator. I like the designs on that one a lot. We get some short stories that take place in the 40s and the 50s. This is the Blood on Two Witch Mesa. And this one here is a sequel to The Big Game. It involves the main character listening to a story about his grandfather, telling him about the ancestors encountering a predator in the old days. That's what that one is. And then, oh, I really like this one. This is Invaders from the Fourth Dimension. And this is my type of story. It's about a small kid that gets 3D glasses and he's able to see this huge alien invasion. This all takes place, I think, in the 1950s. It's strange, and it's a connection between him and his father, but I really enjoyed that one. That one is awesome. This is the one about the pirates. I love the way that this one is drawn. I believe this is from A Decade of Dark Horse number one. With the cover right there that you've seen, that's also the cover to the Concrete Jungle trade paperback, which collects the four issues. Then we get the return of John Schaefer. And this one is, what is this one called? It's like Dark River, maybe? Yeah, I think it is Dark River. So this is John Schaefer again going out into the jungles trying to find whatever happened to his brother, and he confronts another predator. This time around, he's joined by this young lady here, and together they have to fight the predator. And he is set out to find out what happened to Dutch, because he still doesn't have answers. We get a couple of other Dark Horse Comics issues, and then we get The Kindred. The Kindred is an interesting story. This is also one that's four issues long. It's just your basic boogeyman type of story in this little town in Oregon. But I really like the artwork in this one. And all the way in the back, we get the cover right here to the Predator 30th Anniversary, the original comic series. That's the hardcover. Oh, there's the other black and white extra story back here. And then we get some trade paperback covers. Really like that one. Some pinup artwork. Some more Predator covers, trade paperback covers. This is the Predator Cold War covers that connect by Brian Stillfries, which is what you saw here on Art on Board. Cold War pinups here. I will say, if you're wanting to know my opinion on this, the stories collected in here, if you're a fan of the Predator, you're going to enjoy the stories in here. If you're a fan of like the aliens or alien comics that you've read recently in omnibus format, these really aren't that deep. This is more about Predator bad, hunting down humans. Sometimes Predator himself being hunted. Sometimes Predator actually teaming up with humans. But it really doesn't get any deeper than that. I wanted maybe a little bit more, kind of like in the Aliens comics, like how weird the aliens got, or like the talking alien, or the different types of xenomorphs we got. We didn't get that many cool designs, I don't think. I mean, some of the Predators do stand out, especially with all the movies we've seen recently. I think the second volume of this will have more of that. Here is the standard edition cover by, again, Iván Coelho, in case you missed getting it, or in case you wanted the direct market cover. All right, let's take a look at this binding. This one has 1,008 pages, again, retailing for $125. That is sewn binding. There's the eye. And it is printed at the iMac printer. The paper stock in this one, it's thinner than the paper stock they used in Aliens. So you see some of the art bleed through, especially on whiter pages like this. You can see some of the panels coming through. Some of the dialogue narration boxes come through. But I guess the good news for people is that most of the stuff in these type of stories collected in here takes place in the dark. Unless we're talking about the Siberian station here, where there's a lot of snow. So some of the art bleeds through. But just wanted to make sure, yeah, this is what I'm talking about. If you can see like the word bubble there and then some of the frames, but wanted to make sure I mentioned that. And the way that the book lays over, there is a little bit of gutter loss, but luckily towards the beginning, there's not that many spread pages. It mainly is just a bunch of these frames right here, these panels. And I don't want to spoil the big spread page in the first four issues because I thought it was such an awesome spread page. But that's it. That is the same. Is that, why in the hell did I knock on it? Sure, that's my thing now, apparently. If you're interested in purchasing this book, don't forget to check out our sponsor, CheapGraphicNovels.com, your online home for graphic novels and collected editions up to 50% off cover price. They have excellent shipping and prompt and helpful service. Check out their bargain deals for up to 90% off cover price. And don't forget that CGN also takes pre-orders. That way you don't miss out on the hottest releases. And they are currently running a special promotion for you mentees. If you're a first-time customer, after receiving your order confirmation email, reply back to that email and let them know Near Mint Condition sent you their way. They will then apply a free shipping promotional credit to your next order in the U.S. Cheap Graphic Novels, your source for the hottest books with the kind of deep discount, quality shipping, and customer service that will keep you coming back for more. And that was the content, the page count, and build of this omnibus. Let me know in the comments down below if you are picking this up, if you remember reading the stories when they originally came out, what your favorite Predator comic was, your favorite Predator movie was. Leave those comments down below, and if you have any questions, leave them down below as well. Smash that like button on the way out. That goes a long way for us. And it's a very small thing you can do to help the channel. And we are also on Patreon and Spreadshop if you want to go that route. And the links to those places are in the description of the video. But that's it. Everyone, stay healthy and safe out there. Much love.